Mga kapamilya, patuloy kaming maglilingkod. Kahit wala po tayo sa RS
news.abs-cbn.com. Ng inyong mga kwento.
I'm shaking.
Hindi ko may
manalimit. Basta sign off lang daw to, hindi na ipa-play yung podcast. Oh my God, what will I do? Oh my God. So, nagsasign off na po sa TV and later sa radio. Nagsasign off na po. Thank you, Mama Arcana!
Hi, once again, this is Micah. Such a good day to everyone. But the video you just watched a while ago that happened May 5, 2020, that was a sad day. Indeed, most of them, every one of the 11,000 plus employees of ABS-CBN, we cried a lot since then and cried even more during July 10. Ibinasura na ang franchise renewal ng ABS-CBN. And for the third strike, eh, mas umiyak pa noong July 31, 2020 because that was the moment when they said officially our contract will be terminated. We have to remove some employees. Just yesterday, August 31, the final day of my contract with ABS-CBN, and I'm forever grateful for this company. And God knows that. Wow, it's September. Apat na buwan, umiiyak because of loneliness, uncertainty in life, and for a sudden death of a friend. I was really feeling down. I was just really crying. Nagdag po bang pandemic. And I don't know what you're going through. Maybe some of you watching, mawala ka sa trabaho, parang ako. Diba? Oh, hindi mo alam kung anong kakain kinabukasan. Pero may pang internet ka, galing mo. Ang gusto ko lang encourage you. I wanna share to you three things. Paano ako naka-survive dahil alam ko na makakatulong din ito sa inyo.
First point! Nandyan pala, lumilipat yung camera natin ha. Joke! Yung first natin na gusto ko i-share sa inyo kung paano nga ba lagpasan ang mga problema ng madadating pang problema. Kaya pwede mo i-recycle itong advice na ito. Una sa lahat, talk to someone. Don't have to isolate yourself. Minsan, we tend to be soloista. Pero syempre, pag sinolo mo lahat ng yan, ang mangyayari, pity party. Lang po ma-party. It doesn't help you at all. Yes, I understand that when you're going through a lot, ito na lang natin na, no one understands me, no one will really care to ask kung kumusta na ba ako. This is just my problem. We just enjoy it. We enjoy the feeling of being alone, but it doesn't help us at all. Give yourself some time to be alone. But when you are finally ready, come on and open up to someone. Hindi mo naman kailangan pagsigawan sa mundo. Hindi mo naman kailangan sabihin sa lahat. Choose one or two people that you could trust and those who will not judge you to listen to what you're going through. And with that, you would hear another point of view that could help you see the situation in a better view, right? Pero syempre, meron lang po akong gustong advice sa mga mapagsasabihan ng problema. You have to weigh things out. Do I have to give advice right away when this person opens up to me? Or do I just have to listen to this person? Grabe yun, crucial yun. Kasi pag ang isang tao nag-open up sa'yo, napaka-sensitive niyan. So dapat alam mo kung kailan ka magsasalita, alam mo rin kung kailan ka tatahimik. Ganun din naman sa mag-open up. You know kung kailan mo sasalohin, you know kung kailan mo i-open up. Number two! Alagaan ang sarili mo. You have to take good care of your physical self. You know, when you're going through something, your tendency is you sleep a lot or you do not sleep. You eat a lot or you do not eat at all. Sometimes, nagpapaalipin tayo sa emotions natin. But you know, this is what I realized. That seasons in life are just so short. They will have their ending. But how can you reach your ending kung wala kang physical na kalakasan? Diba? How will you run the race if you do not have the physical strength? You can command your body. Did you know that? Uy, matulog ka na. Uy, kumain ka na. You have the authority over your body. It is your responsibility. If you want to see the finish line and you have to finish well, you have to have strength. Kaya kumain ka na. And five. finally, you have to cry it all out. We are all human beings. We are given emotions. Meron tayong luha. Para gamitin din naman natin, di ba? But here's a different advice. Iba, when you just cry it all out, na mag-isa ka lang, or just cry lang, cry, 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 baby. It's another thing. If you cry it all out to God, I cannot explain it, but there's something miraculous, something wonderful, something amazing that happens when you cry it all out to God. Just imagine na parang umiiyak ka and then you just allow God to embrace you. I can't explain it, but something magical happens when you cry it all out to God. Okay lang, kung lalaki ka, hindi yung nakakabawas ng pagkalalaki. Ang tunay na lalaki, umiiyak. Pero mas maganda, ang tunay na lalaki na mayroong paninindigan at faith, umiiyak din naman kay God. Cry it all out, kaya mo yan. So for anyone na may pinagdadaanan ngayon, I may not give you a hug as in hug kasi alam naman natin it's pandemic, social distancing. Kaya virtual hug na lamang. And sana payakap ka din kay God. You know, sabi sa Matthew 11 verse 28, hanggang 30 yata to, basta. Come to me all you who are weary and burdened and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me for I am gentle and humble in heart and you will find rest. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Isn't it amazing that the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the God of the universe, invites you to come as you are. No need to wear masks. Whatever it is that you are going through, it's not a surprise to God. Just come to Him. He provided you friends na pwede mong pagsabihan ang problema mo. He provided you that body to do whatever you can or to rest if you can to give yourself some strength. But He also provided Himself for you to come to Him as you are. So yeah, that's it for now. I hope that will encourage you all throughout the week and for the rest of your days. Once again, like and subscribe! God bless you!
Lord!
Jessie naman yung inaanap nung...